So this is going to be a quick video updating you on my results from my experience with the 30-day shred. And so first a little backstory on this. This is the second time I have done the shred. This is the first time I've completed the shred though. The first time around I was about probably 250, 260, oh maybe more pounds, and I was not in the right headspace to do it, I think. I mean, I made it through level one. Level two, I did it for about 15 days versus the 10. And level three, I made it 2 days, then I quit. So instead of just going back, because I'm gonna give you just a little background on the video itself. So the video is set up as a 3-2-1 system, which is Jillian Michaels, system for weight loss and fat loss and however she says it. So it's 3 minutes of cardio, 2 minutes of 3 minutes of strength, 2 minutes of cardio, and 1 minute of abs. And each circuit, there's three circuits per level. Each circuit is 6 minutes long, and you have a 2 minute warm up and a 2 minute cool down. So the whole entire thing is 20 minutes long. Oh, and so what she recommends is you do it 5 to 6 days a week, at least one rest day, and to do level one for 10 days, level two for 10 days, level three for 10 days. But they say if you cannot make it for whatever reason, like if you feel like you're not ready to move on to the next level, to do it for longer, however long you need to do it. So that's what I did with level two. I did it for about 15 days. Then I did level three. Instead of going back to level two, I just quit. And I think that's the difference between where I was mentally back then and where I am now. Now it was tough. I mean, level one is just a beginner. It just there's and also during there is a the regular move and then the modified move. In every level, there's some kind of modification for you. And I did have to do the modifications for almost everything. Mainly like the push-ups, any plank situations, those kind of things, I always had to do the modified versions. When it came to the ab stuff, I was okay with that, and I think it's because I've done so many ab challenges and things like that over these last 6 months that, that wasn't too bad. Sorry, I heard something out in the kitchen, and I'm not sure what it was. Anyway, so, yeah, sorry. Trying to focus back now. Okay, so that's kind of the backstory of how you do the shred. And anyway, so I did keep track of, oh, that's what I was gonna say. So the only other thing I suggest when you do any kind of workout video like this is take measurements. I've known people who've done the shred who did not lose any weight, and the claims is lose up to 20 pounds in 30 days. That's not gonna happen for most people. And like I said, some people don't even lose weight, but they do lose inches. So I highly recommend to measure anytime you do any of these kind of DVD workouts. So let me turn you around and I will show you my results. Okay, so here is the DVD, and there's information on the back. And this is how I kept track of it in my Happy Planner. I just made myself up a chart for level one, level two, level three, wrote down the days I was going to do them. And I'm sorry, this is probably a bit blurry because it always is. These are my measurements and where I kept track of those. So since you won't be able to read that, I'm just going to show you my results here. So my starting weight was 203.4. I forgot to write my ending weight, but it was 199.2. So I lost 4.2 pounds doing the shred. My measurements, I lost 1/2 inches in my arm, 1/2 inch in my leg, 1 inch in my waist, 5.5 inches in my upper waist, I'll explain that in a second, and 3.5 inches in my hips. So a total of 12 inches lost. Now, what I call my upper waist is that area between right underneath where your bra, your bra area is right under your bust, and then between your belly button. When I say waist, that's at my belly button. So this is just above my belly button. And that's where I always lose pretty quickly, and that's why I take measurements on that area because it's really noticeable when I am doing any kind of weight loss. So those are my results. So I feel really good about this, and let me show you what I'm going to be starting on October 1. So on October 1, I'm going to torture myself again with another Jillian Michaels. This is Ripped in 30. This is completely brand new to me. I have looked at the DVD a little bit to kind of get an idea of what it's about. It looks really similar to the shred. I have gotten a lot of feedback from some of my subscribers that have told me that they liked it better than the shred. So that is encouraging. Same 3-2-1 system. So 3 minutes of strength, 2 minutes of cardio, 1 minute of abs, 4 weeks. So the way it works is there's four levels on this one. The same thing on the DVD, it does talk about doing it 5 to 6 days a week, at least one rest day. So my plan again will be to do it, well, let me show you. So this is my plan. I'll start on October 1 and I will do it for 5 days, because again, I will take a rest day on Sundays and a rest day on Thursdays. These M's right here mean measurements. So I will start on October 1. My last day will be October 28th. So I'll take measurements on the 1st and measurements on the 15th, which is my birthday. And then measurement again on the last day. And again, I kept my information over here to keep track of my measurements. So that is the plan. If any of you have ripped in 30 and want to join me for this challenge, let me know in the comments below. I would love to hear from you and know that there's somebody else out there being tortured by Jillian, just like me. Or if you've done this video and give me any tips, let me know. So thank you for watching, and I will talk to you all in the next video.